Summer yesterday, so I dressed for summer, and then the rain started and the wind was so bad that the whole parking lot looked like it was gonna blow away during worship practice, and I just realized that sometimes that's a really good representation of life. One day life feels like it's summer and all is well in the world, and the next day it feels like all of life and us with it are going to just straight up blow away. And so whether you feel like this is the mountaintop or the valley low for you, God meets you where you are. And he really will encourage your heart this morning if you let him. So let's praise his name, but also let's come with open hearts for what he wants to do and how he wants to meet us right where we are. Great is thy faithfulness.
Today and bright, oh, for tomorrow.
have been held in your hands from the moment that I wake up until I lay my head. I will sing of the goodness of God all my life. All my your voice. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire in darkest night. You are close like no other. I know you as a father. I know you as a friend. Says that we overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. So there's power in remembering what He's done in our lives. There's power to encourage our hearts, to bring hope again. So Jesus, thank you for your goodness. God, I remember the times when I felt like I couldn't go on. Lifted my head. You said, it's gonna be okay. I remember the time when I prayed and you came through. Thank you. goodness of God.
Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't
light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. Yeah. You are waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. Jesus, thank you for reminding us this morning of your goodness and your faithfulness in our lives. Thank you that we get to worship you, not only for what you've done, but for who you are. Thank you that who you are is never changing. You're so good, God.
And I'm sure there's many of us here that need a way maker today. Promise keeper. We need a promise that's kept. You guys can go ahead and sit. We need a light in the darkness. We need a miracle. And that's what our God is. Isn't that right, Russ? Our God is all of that. So wherever you find yourself today, whether you need favor for something to be made a way for you, or you need just an outright miracle, you've given up hope and without a miracle it's not going to happen. You know what? You can trust in God. You can trust in God. Father, thank you that you are that type of God. A God that loves us more than what we can even think or imagine. And Lord, that you promise that you can even do greater things than what we can even ask or imagine for, Father. Exceedingly abundantly more than what we can even think or ask for, Father. So, Lord, right now, I just ask you that you will meet us where we're at, that you will make a way, that you will keep a promise, that you will light up the darkness that we find ourselves in, Lord, and that you will pull us out of that, Lord, and that you will work a miracle in our lives. Thank you, Father, for your refreshing presence, your renewing presence, Father, that your mercies are new every morning. Every morning, Father. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. Well, welcome. That's where you're so welcome back. Morning back. For those, good morning. There you go. For those of you watching online, thanks for joining us here. I just got a couple of announcements. First of all, I decided to wear the shirt and jeans and boots before Buck did, so he's copying me. But we are twinsies today. We're the cool kids. So if you're wondering what the fully engaged shirt is, we did a series earlier in the year from a word that I felt God gave us called fully engaged. And we'll probably pick that back up and remind ourselves of that throughout the year because there was a lot of promises in there. But we have shirts available. We did a sign-up sheet before all the craziness happened, and we didn't order yet because I believe Jamie is getting us a female version of the shirts. I don't know why you guys don't like this, Dakota. This is awesome. Well, that was the female version of that shirt. So, but no, that was a hoodie. But anyway, sorry, Buck. Okay, so we're gonna order really quickly, but she's gonna come up with a couple of versions for female for you ladies, and then we'll order. So, but if you haven't signed up, that sheet is back there. Put your name on there, what size you'd like, and we'll get those ordered pretty quickly. Camp, youth camp is coming up. That's July 13th through the 17th. The camp that we went to before decided to close down for the summer. God miraculously opened up Waymaker, made a way for us to still have. I mean, we had people that were already packing for camp. We had youth that were packing for camp. So we knew it was like when they sent the email saying that we weren't going to have camp, it was like, oh, no, we got to have a camp. Lord, help us find a camp. We found an incredible camp up by on the Thompson Chain Lakes between Kalispell and Libby, and they just happened to have an opening the week that we were having camp. So that's God. That's God's miracle. Before, camp cost $95 a student, and that was a great price. It's actually going up to $130 a student, which I know is a little steep, but that's still actually a great price for four nights. Yeah, and you get the extra day Jamie's still cooking food, which to me, that's the price, that's worth the price of admission right there. But as a church, we want to make sure all kids go. So if there's an, you know, somebody can't afford it, we want to sponsor those kids. So you can give in the offering at any point in time, and you could just designate it as youth camp, and we'll put that directly towards tuition. But we're also having a couple of different fundraisers. On this Friday, we're going to have a garage sale here at the church. Now, that can be dangerous because we don't want all of your junk that you are throwing away, because we don't want to have to throw it away on Saturday. But if you have any nice stuff that you think that would sell at a garage sale, you can drop it off this week here at the church. The side door to the burger stop area has got a code on it. It's so now you have the code to get into that burger stop. Bring your stuff anytime this week and drop it off there, okay? And it is on Friday morning, so we'll have to have it before Friday. I mean, you could bring it early Friday morning, but it'd be better if you bring it earlier than that. The really exciting thing is we're going to do connection groups this summer. So as women's Bible study is winding down, men's probably is going to wind down. I haven't talked to him about it. But we're going to do once a month a connection group. And then we've got three groups. So we've got Nick and Kimberly Whitehead. They're not actually here today. They're up in Sealy Lake, but they're going to do theirs. They've got, basically it's the last Friday of the month, but they have on July, they're actually doing it the last Thursday of the month. But sign-up sheets are back there. They live between Stevensville and Florence. And then we have Russ and Christine Agin. They live up on Airport Road off of Cessna. They are doing it the last Friday of the month. And then Rick and Cynthia Hackey, can you guys raise your hands right there? They are in Corvallis, and they're doing it the first Friday of the month, so this coming Friday. So that's why we're announcing it. It's really important to sign up. You can see the times back there. We tried to make it locations throughout the valley so you could be convenient. And again, we just want to connect as a family. We've been separated. Now it's time to reconnect and just have some fun. Most of those groups will be just real casual groups where snacks, desserts, play some yard games. Kids are welcome. It's families. So it'll be a great time. So, but again, Rick and Cynthia starts this Friday. So if you want to be a part of that group, you need to sign up. And you could sign up for more than one, but really we're just trying to, you know, just pick one. We will probably visit a lot of them. So, because just, you know, I'm that way. So, yeah, as long as they're having food, I'll be there. So, but, if you guys will stand with me, we're going to pray, receive our offering, and release the kids. We don't push offering a lot here because I feel like I don't want you to ever feel manipulated in giving, because that's not what God's about. But I think giving is a very important aspect to our lives. It does say in the Bible, the only thing it does is say, test me in this. If you give, test me in this. I will throw open the floodgates of heaven. So giving is very important. We hold on to our money very tightly. If you're like, you know, we've all got budgets. We all look at stuff. Money's on our mind all the time. And I think to counteract that, we need to be giving. We need to be a giving people. We need to give so that we can see God's return in blessing, and that we can realize that we don't have to hold on to our money at any point in time, because God is there to provide for us. So you can give on the two boxes on the walls, or you can give online on our app. You guys are very generous people, and I really appreciate that about this church. But let's pray over our offering, and we'll release the children. Father, thank you for the opportunity to give to you. Father, you don't need our money, but you want our hearts, Father, and our hearts are often wrapped up in our money. So, Lord, I ask you that you'll allow us to give, and our heart will follow that, Father, that our heart will follow after you, Lord, and that we will begin to trust in you, Father. When you say give, Lord, that we will give, knowing and trusting that you will provide for us, Lord. Father, I ask you that as we give, you will multiply it. You'll help us to be good stewards of it, Father. You'll help us to reach the people in this Bitterroot Valley and regions beyond, churches everywhere. Father, you'll bless us You'll be pleased with what we give. We give with a happy heart and a joyful heart. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. All right, kids, you are released. Buck will be back up in about 5 minutes to bring the word.
Oh, stop right there. So Stacy tricked me. He told me there was a pastor's uniform we were supposed to wear. And so that's why, actually, I just wanted to look like one of my heroes. Aww. Yeah. Yeah, now he's going to cry all service because I said that. Happy Sunday. Welcome to Revive Bitterroot. I'm Buck Rodolph. I get to be one of the leaders here, and glad you're here with us this morning. It's a little emptier once all the kids leave, isn't it? But it's great to have all them in worshiping and being a part of our worship and singing. And this morning, Courtney was kind of over here singing to herself, and my son Stetson came up beside me, and pretty soon he started singing right along with Courtney. So it's awesome to know that the kids are getting it. The kids are learning to worship. And so it's just super amazing to see. I want to pray before we get going and for this morning, probably mostly for me. So, God, we thank you for another day that we can come and fellowship and gather in your presence, God, and worship you. And Lord, I pray that you would just speak to us this morning. Lord God, I pray that the words this morning would be from you, God. It's not me, but it's your words this morning. I pray that you'd help us to receive them this morning. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. So this morning, now that we're live streaming a little bit, I get to do something that I haven't got to do on a television before, and that's, hi, Mom, love you. I told my brother I was going to do that, and he's like, don't do that. I'm totally doing that. I'm the favorite son. So Friday, if you weren't here Friday night, we had an amazing worship night, worship and prayer night. Is there anybody that does hot yoga? Well, we had hot worship. Okay, it was the first time we tried to get the AC on. It was a little warm, but God's presence was here. And I'm sure it was way better than hot yoga. But something, we're going to have a couple more of these throughout the year. And if you guys can at all make it a priority to attend, it is so worth it. It's so amazing, basking in God's presence and just lifting his name up. Plus, because Stacy felt bad, we all went out and he bought us ice cream at Super One afterwards. So that was a bonus. I don't know if he'll do that every time. He will. Okay. If he doesn't, I will. It cost him a whole $4.50, I think. 25-cent ice cream cones at Super One. So this morning, for what God put on my heart for this week, it started probably pushing 2 weeks ago. And I want to give you a little bit of background for what I do for my real job during the days. I work at a place that makes poly pipe fittings. And I do poly pipe? Poly pipe fittings, HDPE. And so we make elbows, tees. We make custom fittings. We do a lot of stuff up there that other companies won't do. And we send a lot of stuff to the East Coast where they're replacing all the ductile iron that's rusting out. The poly pipe will last forever. And so I do all the scheduling of the pipe up there. I will try and stand in one place. I like to move around, but I'll, for video's sake, I'll try plant my feet. So I do all this scheduling. So when custom fittings come in, I schedule the cut lengths. I didn't draw and do any of the fancy stuff. I just take what's been drawn in the measurements and then schedule them to be built in our shop. So the cut lengths for the saw guys, how to fuse them, and they have the drawings to go with. And one of the things that we do fairly often is a manifold, or what we call a manifold, and I'll show you some of those in a little bit. And so I was reading in Ephesians not long ago, and I came across a word that caught my attention and how it relates to my job. So if you want to pull up Ephesians 3:10, if you guys have your Bibles, please open them. There's some words that I shared this morning that I've read over dozens of times and just read over them. And in the last couple of weeks, they've really popped out. And I wanted to pop out for you guys too. So that when you read your Bibles, there's so much amazing things in there and the wording that is used. I just pray that it would come to life for you guys. So Ephesians 3:10. His intent is that now through the church, the manifold wisdom of God should be made known to the rulers and authorities in the heavenly realms. So the word that caught my attention was manifold. And that's because I schedule them at work. And so I know in my work what a manifold is. But I was like, God, what? You're using manifold here in your word. What does that mean here? And so I reread it, and then another phrase stuck out when I reread it. And that's through the church. His intent was that now through the church, the manifold wisdom of God should be made known. So again, like I said, I know what a manifold is, how it relates to my job, but what did it mean here and what was God's intent? So manifold actually, in the Greek, if you want to go to the next slide, is polu poi kalos, or los. And that means many. So the poly, the first part of that, is much in number, many, or colorful. And the poi kalos is many diverse manifestations. Okay? So hopefully you all know what a manifestation is. Okay? And when we're talking about God, to me, God is limitless. And he's obviously diverse. Many diverse manifestations. Okay? So then as I read this and think about it, it comes across that so the many colorful, diverse manifestations of God's wisdom and glory should be made known to the universe through the church. Who is the church?
We are
the church, right? So it's not just through Pastor Stacy. It's not just through Pastor Josh in Missoula. It wasn't just through Billy Graham when he was here. Okay, it's through the church. Okay? And so we can't put God in a box. There's more to this than just coming on Sundays and sitting in a seat, right? It goes beyond the walls of this building. It goes beyond the walls of the church building in Missoula, any church, okay? Yeah. We are the church. So then I got thinking, where else is manifold used? I took a shot in the dark. And I found, so I had to look at various versions, and so I typically read in the NIV, but I found that the New King James Version used manifold more often. So I came across in 1 Peter 4:10. I came across it in the NIV, or in the New King James, but I want to read it in the NIV first. So each of you should use whatever gift you have received to serve others, faithfully administering God's grace in its various forms. And then in the New King James Version, it says, as each one has received a gift, minister it to one another as good stewards of the manifold grace of God. So if we go back to that, it's much in number, many colorful, many diverse manifestations. So God's entrusted us with his manifold wisdom and his manifold grace. Okay? So I want to show you a couple manifolds that we would be making at work. So if you want to pop up the first one. Okay. So a manifold is basically you have one big main pipe that carries the contents. And then you have several outlets that that then distribute wherever they're supposed to go. And you can see by this one here, there's many colors, there's many sizes, shapes. Several of the ends of those are different. So it means they hook up differently in the field, okay? And if you want to go to the next one. Okay, so here's a great big one. Same thing. Two great big main lines with several outlets coming off that are, this one's hooked up. Okay, so a lot of this goes to agricultural purposes. So this manifold is taking water, irrigation, and it's taking it throughout the fields to irrigate and grow the crops. Okay, so I don't want to get ahead of myself here. Okay, go to the next one. This one's a little bit smaller. This was one that we were making in our shop a few years ago. Again, a big main line with several little outlets, okay? I'm gonna get back to this one again in a little bit. Okay, so each of these has many diverse outlets, correct? Each outlet moves the contents of the manifold where it is intended to go. Okay, so then if we're looking back at Ephesians 3:10, if God's intent is that through the church, his manifold wisdom should be made known, that makes us his outlets. What? Okay. Each of us different, going different directions, different lengths, different sizes. We each have different gifts and different abilities. But each of us are called to deliver the contents of God's manifold to where it's intended to go. Okay, it may be as a missionary. It may be as a children's worker in one of these classes. It may be as a youth helper. It may be serving at a food pantry, right? We're each called to different gifts and abilities in different directions. Okay, so you can turn with me to Ephesians 2:10. I'm reading it out of the NIV. For we are God's workmanship, created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared in advance for us to do. Some of the words here that jumps out in the beginning is, for we are God's workmanship, created in Christ Jesus. So I was sitting here this morning, and I was thinking, workmanship. That's not just a willy-nilly thing that God created. These barn doors, which are fairly new, thanks to Russ Agin, okay, these were built with workmanship, handiwork, okay? These barn doors weren't just thrown together without a plan and a purpose. They would not have turned out looking so neat had they been done. Had I done it, I'd have some liquid nails, staples, whatever, and they'd have probably fallen off during worship. I saw some drumsticks flying during worship. That's when you know worship's good. I'd have probably knocked the door off the wall there. But you are God's workmanship, created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared in advance for you to do. Okay, God has put a calling in your life, and your calling looks probably a little bit different than my calling. Okay, Courtney and team can reach people through music and worship, and they can help us all enter into God's presence. I can't do that. That was proved when I requested Devil Went Down to Georgia. And Courtney, knowing my musical ability, replied, when you can play the fiddle and the harmonica simultaneously. That was her nice way of saying, I think, you have a snowball's chance in you know where. Okay? Jamie can't reach the same people as Stacy can. Because Jamie doesn't know the difference between a bass and a pike minnow. Uh-oh. Jimmy Houston or Jimmy Graham? You don't know, okay? And then the flip side, Pastor Stacy can't reach the same people that Jamie can. He doesn't know how to design stuff. I dressed like this because of him this morning. Love you. But this also means that we shouldn't judge others as an outlet and judge others how that they're called to deliver God's contents. I had a story I was debating on telling or not, and I felt like this morning it fits in right here. And about all the various ways God can move and manifest. And I had a conversation with a guy at work, it's probably been about a year ago, the way time flies. And he asked me what I thought. He was smoking extracurricular substances with some guys and got to share God's word and about how much God loved him. And he was asking me what I thought about that and if I thought that was okay. And I had to think, and I'm like, I'm not going to judge. For me, myself, where I am, that's not okay. Plus, I don't even want to know what it would be like. But he was there speaking God's word and the love of God to some guys that I could never reach. I could never have that conversation with those guys. So I wasn't going to judge the situation. I wasn't going to judge what he was doing. Now, if you're doing it as an excuse to do that, that was probably not a good thing. But if he was able to smoke that with them and have the opportunity to share Jesus, who am I to say, no, that's a sin, that's absolutely not right, and judge the situation? Because my God is bigger than that, and I'm not going to stop what he's doing. Okay? Sometimes as an outlet, we think we hit a dead end. Maybe a dead end with a family member, a dead end with a close friend that we've been praying for, trying to share, and we ask, God, what else can I do? God, what else can I do to reach this person? There's no perfect formula, okay? But we wrestle with it. In our own power, we try to manipulate sometimes the situation. We try to manipulate God or manipulate what the Bible says. But really, God's saying, even when you don't see it, I'm still working. Right? We sing about, even when you don't feel it, I'm still working. You might feel like you're at a loss for words or at that dead end and you rest. But instead of manipulating the situation or trying to force something, pray about it and watch God work. Really, what could be happening is the way manifolds are connected in the field. Okay, so I'm going to share a little bit more about that. Okay, can we go back to that one manifold? Anybody have a guess as to what this manifold would be for? I'll help you out. It's about an 8 or 10 inch main line, and each of those outlets are about an inch and a half in diameter. Stacy? I'll help him out.
Fish,
we do a lot of stuff for fish hatcheries, but this one is for an ice rink.
Oh.
Okay? So you have a main line that's going to carry the Freon or whatever is going to refrigerate and freeze the water, and each of those outlets is going to be carried across underneath to help freeze the water. So you have an ice rink. Okay? So what would happen if somebody on one side of the ice rink starts and they're following the directions to a T and they're lining up, they're following the blueprints. And then somebody on the other side of the ice rink decides, oh, that person looks a little off. I'm gonna shift my side a little bit so that we can get lined up, because those outlets have to connect in the middle, right? So if one person tries to manipulate the outcome of where they're supposed to meet in the middle, when they get there, they could completely miss each other. Okay? So if they completely missed, or when they get it hooked up and a couple of those outlets decide they're going to stop working, then when Mr. Stacy comes skating through there, he's going to fall into a puddle of water. Not ice anymore. Okay? But so in our lives sometimes, what we don't see is that God may have another outlet coming to make a connection in the middle and continue his manifold. So when we feel like we're struggling, there's somebody else over here coming with God's word and the contents of what God's wanting to deliver. And between the two of you, we meet in the middle. And now this person that you've been praying for or witnessing to for maybe 1 year, maybe it's 10 years, maybe it's 25 years, when we don't try to manipulate the situation, we meet in the middle, we connect, and now God's manifold can continue with another outlet, another direction.
That's awesome. That's good.
Jesus himself gave us the Great Commission in Matthew 28, 18 through 20. Right? All authority in heaven and earth has been given to me. All authority. Not some. All authority in heaven and earth has been given to me. Therefore, go make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teach them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always to the very end of the age. Always he's with us. This includes through a COVID-19 pandemic, right? Stacy talked a little bit about that last week and not fearing. So all this to say, don't quit or give up your function in the body of Christ. You were made with a purpose. You were made with a plan. You are God's workmanship. He didn't just throw you together. He didn't just put you here right now to just aimlessly wander through life. He put you here for a plan and a purpose. Okay, you are his outlet. You are called to deliver the contents of his manifold to where it's intended to go. Okay? Worship team, you can come back up. The creator of the universe, again, created you with great workmanship. So in closing, before we get back to some more amazing worship, I'm going to say when you feel tempted to put God in a box, for either for yourself or for somebody else that you see, don't. Remember God's manifold. And our outlets all look different. We're all going different directions. And don't let fear stop you for the diverse manifold that you are, the diverse outlet that you are. Last week, Pastor Stacy talked a little bit about Caleb and Joshua and the spies that entered the promised land and how only two of the 12 came back with a good report saying, we got this, God's on our side and we're going to take the promised land. But 10 of them, they quit. Their outlet stopped working. They started fearing and didn't trust the direction that their outlet was taking them. What would have entering the promised land looked like had all 12 of them came back with the same report? Yeah, we got this. Let's go. How many of those 12 saw the promised land? Two. Only Caleb and Joshua, because they kept going. They didn't try to manipulate the situation. They didn't try and manipulate what the rest of them were fearing. Okay? They went and they did what they were supposed to do. Okay? So he's going to use you and he's going to use other people in ways we can't imagine. Okay? But fully engage as God's outlet that he has called you to be. Faithfully deliver the contents where they're intended to go. I'm going to pray, and if you need to respond to anything that Pastor Stacy said this morning, feel free to come up. We'd love to pray for you. If something in this word touched your heart and you need prayer, I'd love to pray for you. I'll hang out here as well. But just worship God now. Let the word of God just fill you, stir you. And when you're reading words, and a word study that I did this week, I don't typically like doing word studies, but to get the full effect of what God had put on my heart with manifold and some of these words, you guys, it's well worth it, because I can only try and get a small portion to you what God has downloaded in me this last week and a half. So it is important for you guys to do your own study and Bible time as well. But I'll pray, and then we can worship. God, thank you that you are a big, big God. And you are the same yesterday, today, and forever. God, I pray that you would just continue to stir our hearts to be the outlets that you've called us to be. God, you're calling us that through the church, we would make known the wisdom and the glory and grace of God. Whatever that looks like to each person. God, and where there's been fear, I pray that you would replace it with boldness. God, because your word says, through faith we can freely and boldly come before you. Thank you for what you're doing in this valley. Thank you for what you're doing in this place right now, God. And we just want to lift you up again in our worship time. God, we love you and we praise you and we pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
You're matchless in grace and mercy. There is nowhere we can hide from your love. You are steadfast, never failing. You are faithful. All creation is in awe of who you are. You're the healer.
You're the healer of the sick and the broken. You are comfort for every heart that mourns. Our King and our Savior forever. For eternity we will sing of all.
Between. worthy of every song we could ever sing. Worthy of all the praise we could ever bring. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you, yeah, Jesus. Jesus, the name above every other name. Jesus, the only one who could ever say. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. Share your manifold love and your manifold grace with those around us. Teach us how to be that outlet for your love to flow through. I will build and I will build my life upon your love. It is a like you love, Jesus. I trust you, Jesus. Holy and holy, there is no one like you. There is none beside you. Open up my eyes in wonder. Show me who you are and fill me with your heart and lead me in your love to those around me. Oh, I've heard a thousand stories of what they think you're like, but I've heard the tender whisper of love in the dead of night, and you tell me that you're pleased and that I never.
You are. It's who you are. It's who you are.
are a good, good Father. God, thank you that we are your workmanship and that you have put a calling on our life. God, I pray that throughout the week you would just help us to see the opportunities that you've put in front of us to share. God, those divine appointments and people that you connect us with throughout the week that just need a hug, that need your love, need your joy, God, and give us the wisdom and boldness to share what you're putting in our hearts for them. Thank you again that we can gather in your presence as a family. In Jesus' name, amen. Don't forget, if you do have some stuff you come across this week that you wouldn't mind putting in the yard sale, that the doors will be locked, but you have the code and the sign-up sheets on the back table for the small groups, summer home groups. If you have any questions on the yard sale, you can see Jamie. Any other questions? Mr. Ratliff. Have a blessed week. Thanks for coming, you guys.